Be sure to enter my Rollercoaster Tycoon 3 Top Tycoaster 2015 competition. Link is in the description. Hello Spartans, Charlotte here, 5000 here, and welcome to episode 25 of Lots of the Ultimate Theme Park 2015. And as the title implies, uploads from now on are going to be a bit intermittent. Owing to the fact that I was in Wales for most of the preceding week, I got back on Thursday, but yesterday I was busy in the editing suite and had to go to Apple Store in Westfield to get my iPod fixed. Well, half fixed, but ended up being replaced. Ah, the joys of the warranty. But, so yeah, I was just too busy yesterday to get a good solid few hours in where I could film. Well, not about skipping an erg session. And right here I realised I'd used the checkerboard technique. To me, I just remember what combination it was, because I was clearing out, I assumed I wouldn't actually change it up. But, anyway, so, what's going down in this episode? Well, a bunch of things. Firstly, I'm building this building. I thought this path up here was a bit bare, so I couldn't think of what to do with it. So, there, don't remember, I just had a brainwave at some point and thought, hey, that would look quite cool. So I decided to go for that. Next episode, I'm probably going to get going on the rock borders, considering I've basically been procrastinating them from day one. Also, actually, when I say the rock borders, I mean like the walls, not like the actual surrounding borders. Speaking of which, I did get going on some of those boards, but I still need to modify the map. I keep forgetting to do that. So here, just do more buildings. I decided to have an entrance at each end, just because reasons. I don't know what this building could be, maybe an arcade or something. I'll leave it to the imagination. Bottom line is, does it look cool? Yes, then it. And if it looks cool, it sits. That's pretty much how I'm rolling with this park. Yeah, I've also had a bit of a roughing relationship, but that's not important. Yeah, it's just bugging me for the last couple days. Anyway. But back to the whole title thing. So yeah, I said I was in Wales this week. I'm also, however, this coming week, I am away on Eton. Essentially, I'm doing a rowing course at Eton College. Don't judge. They're brilliant courses. And yes, while they may be stupidly expensive, they are totally worth every penny. And even if you are a rower or even not a rower, because trust me, like half of everyone who goes is a beginner. I wasn't when I first went, but half everyone goes as a beginner, and they are such a blast. Like, even if you never learnt to row, everyone's really friendly, you always get the best in people. However, you do have to sign up in about January, and they fill up in my experience, they fill up stupidly quickly, although that's just because I'm one of the returning lots, so I have to be really fast. I'm usually pretty lucky, though. And they're starting to know me. But back to this building, I just sort of made it up in my head and had a rough idea of how I was going to put it together. Then I hadn't really planned out the details, so all these trims and the windows, and obviously the pipes. Gotta have pipes in the Wemmer Park. I think the other side of this park actually might not have quite so much Dwemer stuff in it. I might try and make it a bit more, I don't know, maybe Windhelm themed, maybe bring up or put some more medieval into it, maybe bring out the Windhelm set more. But there again, it's kind of hard. I've sort of just got into this mode of doing medieval with golden wall grooves and pipes. I think I could do pure. Well, I could do pure medieval if I tried. But I've just sort of got into this habit. I'm probably not going to be uploading for about another week after this. Actually, though, on the second uploads, while I am on these, I probably will have a lot of time to film time lapses, but I may not record them and upload because I don't think the broadband is very good. However, I do have another video in the works. So, me and three of my mates, we got together last week now. I haven't had a chance to edit this because I was in Wales, but we got together and I'm just going to keep it quiet there. But the video is in the works, however, it is taking a butt ton of time to edit. So, keep your eyes up on my channel for that. If you're not subscribed, then get subscribed. Because that should be absolutely hilarious. And you'll be able to meet some of my mates. And I will link to them in the that video. So here I was just doing more pipe works and figuring out the arrangements. I think this one may have been a bit too symmetrical, but I don't care. And if it's Rollercoaster Tycoon 3, it fits. That doesn't make any sense, but still. So you may notice I keep on hitting the pause and play buttons whenever I'm placing the steam things. That's so that I don't have all the pipe steam misses, which I admittedly I cocked that up on the main street. I may go back and fix it. But what that does is it makes sure that the pipe, the steam emitters, they're not all in phase. Like, the problem with what I ran up notice on the main street when I hit play is that they're all doing exactly the exact same time. Whereas this, I've got them all out of sync, so it looks much more natural. Less like a robot. So here, just do more path borders. And really, I was just thinking, let's just start trying to wrap up this area. That gap, though, is still bugging me. Also, I may be able to get a new laptop soon. However, I do need to try and persuade my parents to stretch to the budget allocation that I require. I mean, unless anyone knows a gaming laptop with like a 970M in it for less than £1,000, then please get in touch, because I'm seriously... Because if that's the case, then I could be very easy to talk to my parents. Because at the moment, I'm in a set budget of grand, and what that could probably get me quite comfortably is something with a 960M, but the 960 isn't a very powerful graphics card. I really want the 970, because that'll just handle my work, handle everything much better. I also intend to get some games for it. Most notably, Skyrim Legendary Edition, Fallout 3 Game of the Year, which I may try and get my Xbox for my birthday, but I do want to get on PC so I can record it. And I also want to get Fallout 4 when it comes out. Well, I may get some time. I also might get GTA 5 as well. Actually, no, having seen the trailer the new Black Ops Zombies, that looks really good. I might get that on PC as well. But anyway, hopefully once again your laptop and my birthday comes around, or Christmas, expect some new fireworks on my channel. There might be some more game videos, because I'm sorry, my current laptop, it's some old HP of a Core i3 370M, it's just not suited for gaming. I'm surprised it holds up this, but I'm pretty much killing it every time I put a render for it. Because the CPU, even now, is really hot. Like, I can feel it on almost in like hot quarter of the way of the laptop. So like, CPU's in the back left, I can feel it back front left, where the hard drive is, or that may be the hard drive kicking off that heat as well. But bottom line, my current laptop is hard drive only. Actually, that's my other problem with a £1,000 laptop, actually. It's very hard to get SSD plus hard drive for less than a grand. Well, actually, I was looking at a laptop PC specialist. The problem is, it's 15 inches and not TN. Or rather, it's not IPS. However, it does look like something out of Tron. Or a Batmobile, depending on how you want to interpret it. It does look it looks unbelievably cool. But if I could, I would rather have an Asus G751. If you want to see a laptop I'm talking about, go on to PCSpecialist.co.uk. It's called the Proteus 2. Have a look at that. If anyone knows actually what the base chassis of that is, because I know that that's not its actual name, but if anyone knows the actual chassis for that, because I want to see if you can get it configured somewhere else for cheaper. But I am slightly apprehensive about that laptop because it's not an IPS panel. But you can get a 970M in that for, okay, 1,100 quid. I might be able to stretch that. So that may be an option. Problem is, it's only 15 inches. G751 is 17. So that just gives you that little bit of extra screen to play with. And obviously the G751 is IPS, has a Blu-ray drive. Proteus has no optical drive. I mean, the G751 is more expensive, but there again, you're basically just paying for more hardware and more hardware that's also just better quality because it's Asus. Also, the G751 has a PCI Express SSD, well, N.2 that runs over a PCI Express laser, which runs like a tank. Seriously, I've seen the Crystal Disk Mark scores for that thing. It hits over about 900 megabytes per second. Holy balls. You get my point why I want this thing. Is in my mind, one of the best bang for the buck 17.3-inch laptops money can buy. So right here, wow, I realise I've actually not talked a lot about Rollercoaster Tycoon 3 in this episode. So right here, I was doing like a gate thing to kind of separate each area. I'll probably do one on the other side as well. Probably use these to kind of separate the park. And then just do more lampposts and just some general stuff at this point. Like here, I was really, this episode is predominantly that building and a butt ton of pathwork and more pipes. But I really like how this area is coming together. I mean, next episode I'm probably going to do the mass wallsmith, which I've basically been procrastinating for about a month. And I'm pretty sure this project has already taken up at least 2 months. Holy balls. Wow. I guess I should have known what I was getting into when I tested the ultimate theme park 2015. So here, just do more plants and trees, and at this point I delve into N7's ornamental tree set and struggled to find a tree that I like, but actually I quite like this one. It's a Chinese tower, the immature one. And then at this point I realized, wait, shit, I don't remember what tree I was I didn't remember what tree I was using. So I just placed the plants and then dashed back into the set just and found it again. So at this point I was nearly done. I just had some fences left to do. I did consider doing the inside fences, but I decided no, let's just do that next episode when I get a chance. Although, predominantly for the foreseeable time until I get around to Rollercoaster Tycoon 3, I'll probably be editing that aforementioned.com video. So, subscribe to my channels to keep your ears out for that. Whatever. But anyway, I'm Shower25000. You're watching Rollercoaster Tycoon 3 Let's for the Ultimate Theme Park 2015. And this is youtube.com/marshmallowmurderers. Please subscribe to my channel, check out the rest of this series, and check out the rest of my other videos. And if anyone knows a £1,000 gaming laptop with a 970M, then get in touch. Peace out, guys. You are awesome.